possible.
Good day, everybody. We're back for round two. I'm torn between doing like a soul lich or a primalist, but I think I like the lightning leap. So we're gonna do that. Let me see where I'm at. I don't even remember where I'm at with my skills. Let's see, I kind of wanted to do like an all leap thing. I'm trying to kind of like chart my course, you know what I mean? Yeah. Nice as the music is, I got my own tunes right now. Just in thinking mode. Leaping on people and doing the damage. And as Shaman, I'll get Earthquake, Avalanche, Storm Totem. Storm Totem seems to be the one. It really seems to want me to dual wield with it. Axe or mace? Whenever you get wings of lightning, each time one of your storm crows, okay, so your storm crow pet, attacks that consume wings of lightning, causing the basic attack to deal to chain to additional times. Okay. That's the way to go then. Then I'm gonna want Storm Crows. One Storm Crow deals more damage, has more health. Winged Raptor. I mean, that's kind of cool. Thunderous Blast, Crow Storm deals more per contributing crow. So that'd be better if I had more crows, not less. Shocking Display is a shock chance. More damage, have increased critical strike. I'll probably go that way. Deal more spell per stack. This one, I think, looks like it turns them, like, physical. They have chances to shred armor. They're faster. Okay. That'd be kind of cool, too. I want to be, like, a leaping thunderstorm, you know what I mean? So then that's kind of what I'm going for. Get creative with it. Feels good to be original. I know you can min-max the game, but I don't know. I feel like it takes a little something away from it. So I do Stormcrow. These two. Two more. Probably Storm Totem. Moves at random, pulling in nearby enemies and dealing physical damage to them. Or channel the Winter's Might. You have no mana while channeling, the initial cost will be reduced. Earthquake could be kind of cool. Tornado, it's Tempest Strike. A melee combo that cycles through cold, physical, and lightning. It triggers the element Tempest. Wind Tempest is a small twister. Rigid Tempest is cold projectiles. Lightning Strike is the Thunder Tempest. That could be kind of cool. Thunders the ground in front of you. The enemies alongside. That's cool too. Fucking. I want to leap on them and slash the fuck out of them. And then I guess they summon Stormcrows. There's a combo in there somewhere. We'll figure that out. Storm, okay. Meanwhile, my passives. Primal Strength. I don't know which ones are just movement, traversal strength, lightning, melee strength. Okay, so both are good for me, so I am on the right path with these two. Attunement is lightning. Yeah, I get summoned Stormcrows in a bit. Wisdom of the Wild is spell damage. I could get to 16 with just these two. It's melee damage, but it's also minion melee. Tempest Bond, there we go. Lightning physical. Doubled when you have a minion. Yeah, and that goes with the crows very nicely. Okay, Tempest Bond. Deal additional most damage with two-handed weapons. Depends on the type used. So staves are lightning damage. That's interesting. That'd be kind of cool. Like with like a lightning rod. Sky Warrior, Demonic Infusion, well that's more attunement. Sky Warrior seems really good. Tornado scales off physical spell damage over time. Earthquake is physical, melee, strength, attunement. So attunement affects pretty much everything I do. And right when I go out I get lightning spell. Oh wait, minion totem attunement. Okay, so that counts for minion scaling, so increased minion damage counts for totems. That's pretty cool. So it'd be lightning totem, crows, leap, and then the lightning strike, and then like maybe channel like an aura around me. It seems pretty good. I think I could have fun with that. Oh yeah, old bro got like taken by a drake, and that's a struggle. Okay, so one minion. Physical damage. All that jazz. Seems good.
Right.
Funny bear man go leap leap. Am I loading? Oh, okay. I was like, wait a minute. Kind of in the way up here, aren't I? Are you looking at me? Are you looking at me? I'll leave it on you. What a coincidence. What's up, Marco? How you doing? I like that healing my wolf makes it go berserk and get bigger. He's a good boy. Good, just woke up. That's what's up, dude. I'm having some coffee and almond flour gluten-free banana bread. Banana bread, it's pretty good. Last epoch's fun. I'm playing shaman and I'm playing like a lich, which is kind of cool. The lich has been pretty fun. They play very much like differently, so it's like if I'm in the mood for one, I have the other. This one, I summon totems. they shoot thorns, and then I, like, they have, like, little, like, weird, like, little bits. And then I leap on them. And I'm trying to go a build, like, where I can do all sorts of stuff. Look how, I'll show you how intricate these builds are in a moment. So, like, not only do you level up, like, your passives, and you have all these trees to choose from, and abilities that unlock, you have your each skill you use. What's this moth doing? Too friendly. You have ability, every single ability you use gets its own XP as you use it, and you can upgrade them in all these different ways. This is just the leap ability, so I'm gonna go larger AoE, less mana cost. And I think I'm gonna go, like, create storm bolts when you leap. Storm bolts occur frequently. Rejuvenating storms, additional spells per attunement, and that's the one I'm leveling up in the passive, so it synergizes. And I haven't even gotten to the shaman yet, I'm just the primalist. But yeah, this should be pretty cool. I'm really digging the... It's like a very zen, like, customization game, you know? It's not wildly difficult yet, of course, but I get the feeling that there will be different builds for different stuff. And it's just this sort of, like, the freedom to customize it feels really nice. It's interesting playing this after playing Lost Ark, because there's things that redeem Lost Ark about this, and there's things Lost Ark could learn from it. The same time. So let's see, Savage Impact. Aspect of the Mantis. Cooldown is reset when you kill an enemy with a short leap. That could be good if I want to do short leaps. Fury Leap now deals damage based on how far you leap. See, I like that. I like the Wind Hammer. That's pretty cool. Leech a portion of the damage dealt as health. That's pretty cool. Savage Impact. Maybe I'll do that too, that lightning, brutal and bleak. Let's see, Warrior's Entrance. When you land, you and your minion gain additional melee damage. That's pretty cool. I like that. Warrior's Entrance seems good. Your pack leaps with you. I'm not going Beastmaster, but that's pretty cool. All ailments are cleansed. Your minions heal when you leap. Really pick leap critical strikes more often. You below half health, it always crits. That's pretty cool, especially if you take the lifesteal one. Violent upheaval consumes upheaval's mana. Oh, okay, uses the spell automatically when you land. There's like an upheaval ability. Relief has a chance to cast summon vines at your location. Regen stamina. Whenever you kill an enemy with any other skill, Fury Leap comes back up. Interesting. Ambush Predator. Let's see. Yeah, I kind of like the Storm one, right? Chance to reset Fury Leap's cooldown, kill enemy with the Storm Bolt. As I land, I cast the Storm Bolt. Alright. I need 3 points here to make a connection. Savage Impact does more with the modifiers. Let's see. I could go the aspect and, like, keep kind of, like, thunderclapping around on people. I don't really need the damage yet, so we'll go for the larger... We'll rush for the storm. That's kind of what I want to do. And then on this path, I'm going, I think, for... You gather... Let's see, melee. Gathering storms, melee attacks. Larger areas, chance to get an additional storm stack. So you leap on them, and then you bring the Thunder Crows. Each time one of your Storm Crows attacks, they consume a Wings of Lightning, causing their basic attack to chain twice. So leap on them, chain lightning them all. Pretty cool. I'm going to go with that. We need 3 here. Tempest Weapon, what is that? That's a cool like, connector. Gathering Storm deals additional spell damage per damage if you equipped an axe or a mace. I'm thinking about going staff. So maybe we'll hold off on that one. Whenever you use Gathering Storm, you gain mana. See, I might need mana. That might be a good one. And then dual wielding now casts Storm Bolts. I could dual wield. Seems to really want me to. I saw some people with like the overlay. Maybe the overlay on the map. melee lightning damage? Hell yeah. Exactly what I'm after. In fact, so here's the other thing, is we can infuse it. This stuff. I don't know if I have too much, but let's see. Void that cannot can be applied. Health on melee hit. Still 18 more forage ability. And add those two. Pretty good. Oh yeah, it's weird because it stays in the equip slot, and then you have to re-equip it. I forgot about that.
No room.
Alright, let's see, Dreamcatcher. Lose two attunement, but I'd get health.
No room.
More lightning, more better. Wish there was an easier way to sell. There's got to be some I'm missing where you can sell multiple stuff. That portal does not work. Game's a little laggy still. We still have a lot of updates to do. Oh, we're lagging. Are the servers about to do another restart? Yeah, other people are feeling it. Oh, can't move. There it goes. The poor servers, man. Good level 15 item. Okay. Sold the bracers on that though.
Right.
Thank you. there an auto loot? Gotta be an auto loot, right? Auto pick up everything. Whatever. They said on the forums that they all talked about it, even all the devs agree they don't want it in the game. That's interesting. This is one of the few times we all completely agree on something? I wonder why that is. Oh, Helmet of Sparks. Use some strength, but I'd get stun chance and regen. That's Helmet of Hope. Four strength. I'd get one more attunement. Let's see how it feels. Rest now, you did good. Alright, well, I found the keeper's lost homegirl he was looking for. Poor guy. I like the idea it's gonna be a big AoE when I land. 75% increase. Boom! Yeah, there we go. What do my numbers look like when I do lightning? Let's see. I think the 4 strength is better than the 1 attunements. Every point of attunement gets 2 mana, and the skills that rely on it innately. Weird. I don't know how much they go up, though. Armor by 4%, the skills that rely on it. Okay, so strength is armor. Vitality is health. Dexterity is dodge. And I think ward is like magic resistance. Intelligence grants ward. Interesting. Okay. Well, let's just try it directly. So Fury Leap is strength. They're both strength and attunement. So 161 and 87. And then I equip the thing. It goes 144. It's 79. So that's more reliant on... Wait. Okay, so I definitely want just strength over attunement, kind of, but it's they're both good. Got it. So more numbers is the answer. Which one's better? Whichever one has more numbers. Bigger numbers win. Okay, so you're kind of encouraged to go all the way through and then head back to camp. Oh yeah, hence the teleporty guy. Cool. It's very chill. It's got a good flow, man. I got a good flow to this. Yeah, I wonder what point I should start, like, thinking about breaking items with good shards in them. Probably not till much later, right? Not till, like, my level up stop being really frequent. That'd be my best guess. Let's see, I wonder if my leap counts as a spell. Because then increased spell damage would be a whole thing. Maybe I'll try Tempest Strike here. Wow, eats a lot of mana. Does a ton of damage. Let's see which path Tempest. Maybe Tempest Strike is what I'm looking for. Let's look at the ends. Channeling Avalanche now casts Frigid. Cloudburst Conduit. Whenever you cast Thunder Tempest, you also cast it around a Storm Totem. That's pretty good. Tornadoes cast from Whirlwind Tempest. Maybe that's the move. A few really strong melee hits. Melee Strength, Physical, Cold Lightning. Might be better, because this seems like hitting them multiple times is the way to do it, right? Whereas, how do I get rid of this? Don't tell me I can't get rid of it, dude. That would suck. Grant you a stack of Gladiator, which grants you additional, you and your minions additional damage. Wind Fury Force deals more in a larger area. There we go. That's a good solid start. Looming Gale melee summons Tempest. Wait, create a Tempest Totem. As Tempest in the corresponding area. Okay. Tune Sky Opener. That sounds about right. You now expend storm stacks when you use Tempest Strike. Okay. Scheme of the Architect. If you have 50 intelligence, you double the effect of your totems. Or you cast Thunder Tempest. Increased attack speed and costless mana. That might be a good way. Soaring Blows. Specific type. Yeah, this one doesn't seem to limit my weapon choice. So I'm thinking it's better for two-handers. Storm Companions. Thundering Tempest shocks enemies it hits. Recast. Thunder, you also cast Storm, okay. I could do the three Tempest types whenever I'm slicing, that'd be kind of cool. Lowering the mana cost seems pretty significant. Alright. Oh, that's cool, yeah. Fucking stuff shoots out of it. Yeah, I like that. Yeah, I just want to do like really, like a few heavy hitter strikes when I land really precisely, you know. And later on, we'll replace these thorn totems with storm totems. That's awesome, yeah. Slam the ground, fucking spark lightning shoots everywhere. Dude, yeah, I'm making tornadoes, lightning storms when I strike. Fuck yeah. Oh, that's so rad. A unique item? Bronze pike? Fire damage, cast fire on kill, that's pretty cool. 26 melee damage. Now this was lightning and crit and stuff. Level 19 item. Ooh, big boy. Chance to chill on hit and heal when kill. Heal and kill and chill. And Netflix, obviously.
Thank you. still feel the flame searing across me. My eye. Yet.
Oh, this is that commander dude that has no wings and rides the griffin. Confront horse specs, Orion. Sure. Totes, Orion's dog.
Reaching me was impressive, but it's mine! Come, Emberwing!
Oh, you're Emberwing. Okay, good boy.
Burn.
Me burn? How about you chill? Huh? Huh? You ever think of that? What's the trash I need to drop? Need to drop? Shift right click.
No room.
All right, another boss bites the dust.
Get me out of here.
Hey, are you homeboy I've been looking for? Oh, they just left like the epoch shard just sitting on the chest. Like, yeah. Power of ship reality. We'll get to it. I gotta, you know, I just gotta wake up first.
There. The shards of the epoch are safe. I was worried for a moment.
This guy's got a great beard.
The epoch. Oh, it's a Terra's most sacred artifact, holding great power. The power to travel through time. If Raya were to get his talons on it, he would surely win the war. More than that, he'd be untouchable.
Okay, so there's like, what
now,
do we do now?
I find a new course of action. Take the witch, speaking of. Let's head back to camp. I must reach Lena at once.
Alright, let's head.
Good stretch.
Guess I'm loading? Oh, did I get the server fail again? Huh, okay. Just lagging. It's too bad. I see people being pretty rude to the company in chat, and it's like, guys, I get they're pretty much almost an independent company. Believe it or not, that are like, oh, lame company, shut them down, no servers. It's like, dude, I would rather have them struggle with a little technical issues and make a great game than have some AAA game that's gonna gachapon a thing, like rug pull out from underneath me. Which is kind of tragically how it goes very often. Same thing, just better? Hell yeah. Anything but one more strength? Yes. Better move speed and dodge? Yes. Oh wait, one attunement, more damage. This Banjo-Kazooie throwback music. Pickaxes are considered an axe. Fair enough. I guess that makes sense. You look at it the right way. You know I'm playing Shaman? Come on.
Itera's blessing.
Yeah, I found them. They died. XP, I'm sorry. Makes you so cold when you're just like, yes, plow through everyone. Meep. This is a game, if I ever got hands on an N64 controller, you're gonna have to play, would be Banjo-Kazooie. The soundtrack we're listening to, that somebody made an 8-bit remix of it we're listening to, came out by Shuffle. Yeah, look up Banjo-Kazooie, dude. It's a weirdly, it's a hilariously, like, cynical game from the people who made Donkey Kong Country and, Conker's Bad Fur Day. Dude, Rareware games with Diddy Kong Racing and stuff. Ugh. Legendary company. Legendary company.
He's back, and it's all thanks to you. He's been quiet since he returned. If you could speak with him, I'd be grateful.
You're back. Now, we must protect the Epoch. Find a way Soraya won't get to them.
Alright, but like...
Hopefully. Itera left their secrets to us, and to us alone. I have, ideas. The Lena will disappear.
Kinky ideas.
Well, we are keepers after all. Protectors of Itera's past. Collectors of lost history. Do you think we've made a mistake?
What do you mean?
Going through the motions. Keeping the shards hidden. It's all been ritual.
Yeah, I guess maybe if you told everyone about them, we'd have like a different society.
I feel as though drastic times are upon us.
Might be.
No, you know about them too. I apologize. You might become part of something greater. I only have 2 shards, but that's enough. I'll keep them safe.
I guess one to move through time, and then one to leave in a different point in time, and then to sequester
Lena,
them away, right?
I'm sorry.
What are you doing? What
I'm
are you doing?
Sorry to you too.
What do you mean you're sorry?
This is what's best for us all.
You sure?
With the Epoch's power, I'll finally be able to.
What? Where did he go? I think it's supposed to be taking me somewhere. I think it's just a little laggy because the servers are loaded. Alright, well I'm gonna make a fresh coffee while this loads.
first of the moon.
What do I do? That guy just went to the future without me? I think I was supposed to go to the future with that guy. It just, I thought it was loading, it just didn't take me. Maybe it's just bugging. Is the game in like two? Oh, failed to match me. Damn. Alright. Can I play this character offline? Failed to match me. Yeah, I guess it's just bugging. It must be why all these people are here. Hey, it worked this time. All right. Yeah, just still server hiccups. Gotta be patient. It happens. Well, it went through this time. I think something was supposed to happen here? Inspect the Shard of Epoch. Yeah, I was supposed to teleport up here. Alright. But here it is, anyway. The Shards of Epoch. You fucking were just here, and then that guy was just here, but now there's a Shard's here, and he's not here, and it's like, what the fuck, bro? Can't just leave this lying around. Although, the first boss you beat, when you beat him, it's just lying on a chest, like not even locked in it, next to the dude. So.
What is this place? The spirits, they are in pain.
What kind of stuff are we looking at? It's a level.
Okay.
We got the chops, we got the hops. Got the choppies. Tempest Strike penetrates enemy resistances. Interesting. I feel like I could still use the attack speed and mana. But let's see what comes after. Fulminating Strike shocks the enemies. Rigid Tesla chills on hits. Channels while channeling Avalanche does a thing. Wind Booster, whenever you and your allies touch, you get haste. Ceaseless Cyclone, whenever you cast Whirlwind Tempest, you have a chance to create tornadoes. Consumes mana equal to the portion of the tornado's mana cost. Devastating Whirlwind. Tornadoes from Wind Tempest deal more damage. Channeling Avalanche. guess. Well, I don't want to channel Avalanche.
Gladiator, but wait.
Deals more damage. It costs additional mana. Go the whole other direction and cost more mana and more. Tempest Strike can no longer cast Frigid. More attack speed gained. Deals more melee damage. Removes Wind Tempest. Removes Frigid Tempest. Crashing Waves. Melee. Removes. So this is just make it crazy chunky strikes. I like Sky Opener next. Spend Storm Stacks. Do I gain Storm Stacks? Spend Storm Stacks when you use Tempest Strike on an enemy he at least was one. Storm Bolts cast this way deal more damage. Melee combo and strike on the strike triggers. I don't get Storm Stacks though, do I? Lightning Strike Thunders, which expends Storm, which is an expanding Storm of Lightning Bolts, but I don't get Storm Stacks with it. Maybe I get them from another way? This path seems pretty cool. I can cast all three, no matter which type I'm doing, so all of them can do everything. Storm, Frost, and Cold all at once each time. Higher chance to freeze, higher chance to shock, higher chance deals more damage with wind. This direction, melee hits grant you Gladiator of Lagan for 8. Grant you additional spell damage. Can trigger a maximum 3 times per second. This way I would go Wind Fury, I think. Storm Rider Compa- yeah, I would go into Wind Fury to Sky Opener if I could find a way to generate Storm Stacks. Spell damage with two-handed weapon. Tempest Strikes deal additional per axe or mace. And additional spell damage while casting with two-handed weapon. Rot's Arsenal. I could do these two and go all elemental autos. That would be kind of cool. Gladiator of Lagonda's shared spell damage buff per point. Does not scale with points allocated. Interesting. In my leap, I'm still going to go Leap creates Storm Bolts while leaping. Hell yeah. Occur with more frequency. So which one does the Storm Bolts? That would be spend Storm Stacks when you use Tempest Strike. Storm Bolts cast this way do more damage. Tough to say, man. Tough to say. I don't have to cast it as often. Where is here? here is the void. All right, let's go to the refuge. I remember this part. So is lightning not considered spell damage then? Guess not. Physical lightning, melee, area, movement, traversal. Physical lightning, cold, melee, strength, attunement. So both run off strength, so it should go strength. Little mana regen belt.
What?
What's happening to the last refuge? Guard sent me. Where are we going? I got a shard. Yeah. Long story, but yeah, I'm protecting it.
You were foretold by the Lord, it's a long story, yeah, but the elders, go talk to them.
God.
Wait, did I not accept? Over you. Accept. I'm supposed to have lightning. Freely creates storm bolts while you are leaping. While you are leaping. So I leap over things and I electrocute them. That's dope. Okay. What? Hell yeah. Okay, so I definitely want attunement. I would like to go the Blizzard Cyclone Storm. So my autos are just casting storms. That sounds pretty cool. Oh yeah, there's like lightning bolts when I'm leaping. Okay, so it shocks stuff as I'm landing on them and while I'm jumping over them. I gotta get to the council, bro.
God be with you.
I got lightning to jump. Gotta go save his friends because his dog isn't gonna leave him and his friends will take his dog for him. No, not Minimus. Minimus the good boy. Yeah, this part's too dark. There's a brightness setting, right? Thank you. The dark zone is like really dark.
Be with you.
I've cleared a path. Get the fuck out of here. Cool. They have like a mushroom mine for food. Yum yum. Can be cast repeatedly to create multiple at once. Pretty cool. Damage per second, and then they overlap. 7 seconds. Maybe, we'll see. See how that is. That's pretty cool. Expend storm on hit. Leap on people, do okay. And we'll get over here and we'll do all the things. You can also cast Wind Tempest when you use lightning or cold. You can also cast Thunder when cast cold or physical. You can also cast Frigid when casting physical or Tempest. Okay, yeah. So they'll do all three at once. It'd be pretty rad. And then my leaps will summon lightning. Okay, right now, so when I leap over them, I do lightning to them. Alright, sounds pretty good to me.
Where are you going?
Help, they're coming over the walls. It's fine. Yo, get out of here. Orders to evacuate. This guy's just letting them blast him in the helmet. Come on. Baron Nashor, is that you? That idiot died to Baron. Squish into worms, squish into worms. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna go crows instead. Get the fuck out of here, bro. What are you doing? No, can't pray, you gotta get the F out. Farm where there are like weird armadillo creatures hang out. Alright. Lucky level 13, let's go. Shining, shimmering ring of evasion. I can show you the loot.
Off me. Only a little longer.
The crits from almost 400. Well, 350, I think.
Longer. I'll be right behind you.
No room.
Failed the matchmake. Failed the matchmake. Third time's the charm. Looking like it's doing a thing. Are we loading in? This is the big RNG of the game. I'm in loading queue. Oh, really? Can you play offline and still progress? Really into the game, it's just I just gotta be able to play in a way, you know. Come on. Come on. Maybe not. Can I play my last Epoch character offline? Benefits, rewards, drawbacks. Let's see what this says. Running last offline is compatible. Here we are. 1.0 state. Taking cues from Diablo. Can you play last Epoch? Play it offline, letting you choose how you want to play. Doing so is pretty self-explanatory. When you launch the game, play offline. Some drawbacks from the offline. You will not have access to cycles. Oh. However, this does not mean you're not relying on the servers, which have been a little shaky. You can pause the game when you like. It's up to you when you want to play. The online will be fairer, more complete experience. There's reasons why you must choose offline, especially if you don't want to be at the mercy of your internet servers. You cannot switch freely between offline and online play, at least with the same characters. Okay, so I gotta have an offline character, pretty much. This is largely because you can manipulate the game, potentially add cheats, etc. And ruin the game for yourself, but I guess if, you know, some people do, that's how it is. That's too bad, because I kind of want to keep playing, right? Well, maybe we'll just, wait till they figure a thing out, I suppose.
matchmaking. It keeps failing. All right, you guys. Maybe I'll be live with some League later. I feel like I'm just going to probably grind some offline characters, and we'll get back to it.